Hey everybody, today we are talking about can boric acid cure BV? And we're going to jump into that. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN, and I recommend boric acid for lots of different reasons. But in this video, we are going to dive into what boric acid is, how to use it to help to clear a bacterial vaginosis infection. Does boric acid help to treat bacterial vaginosis? How to use boric acid for vaginal infections such as BV, how long boric acid takes to treat BV, and other treatment options that might be best for BV if you are having this infection. You should watch this because we're going to talk about what is boric acid. Boric acid is something that is found in nature, in a lot of things that we use around the house, and also in treatment options for infections such as bacterial vaginosis. It is a salt called sodium borate. It is actually found in a lot of chemicals and things around the home, and most of us are just unaware that it exists. You may have heard of it being in roach. You may also have heard that it is found in roach poison and different baits that can be used around the home, but it's also found in things like artificial tears. And so we know that this is very effective with helping with treatments, infections, and helping to kill things around that doesn't belong. Now with that, it is also a treatment option for bacterial vaginosis. Before we dive into this topic any further, I do want to place a huge disclaimer here that if you do choose to use boric acid for a vaginal infection, it can only go in the vagina. Please do not take boric acid by mouth, as it is poisonous and can cause serious damage. However, research has shown that when you place this in a capsule form and place it in the vagina for infections, it actually works marvelously without increasing the likelihood of you having any poisoning in your body internally or any complications from it. Now, if you are pregnant, another disclaimer here is that do not use boric acid during your pregnancy or while lactating. There isn't enough research to support using it in this format or letting us know whether or not this can actually affect your growing pregnancy or your baby. And so the best thing to do is to avoid this kind of treatment during pregnancy or lactating. So boric acid is very effective in treating bacterial vaginosis. And research has shown that it does have some efficacy with yeast infections, but not as great as that for bacterial vaginosis. And so with that, if you are having a yeast infection, the best option is to treat with an antifungal medication versus boric acid, but some people do have some benefits from trying the boric acid. With bacterial vaginosis, it works quite well because bacterial vaginosis is an infection that has to do with the acidity of the vagina. And so if your vagina has become less acidic, if you add more acid in the format of boric acid, you're able to cure the infection and also prevent a future infection as well. So where do you get boric acid? Well, you can get this at a pharmacy. You can get this on Amazon. You can literally purchase this wherever they sell them, as long as it's in a capsule form and that the instructions are specific for using them for a bacterial infection such as BV. You should not use boric acid for any other types of infection outside of BV and yeast infections. They do not cure STDs such as gonorrhea, chlamydia, trichomonas, or any other infections that might be present in the vaginal area. Our topic today really is focusing on how quickly boric acid may help to cure your infection. And so can you cure it in a day? No. Bacteria in the vagina that has overgrown really will take quite some time to be able to be reduced in number to what is normal, like a normal range for your vaginal area. And so in general, I would recommend treatment with boric acid for a minimum of 7 days. Now, dependent on the brand that you get, the instructions or the directions on that packaging may be slightly different from others. So it's very important that you actually follow the instructions on the particular brand that you've received. In general, all boric acid suppositories are made of the same exact sodium borate salt, and it is also not mixed with any other compounds, or should not be mixed with any other compounds. There's one way, easy way, that you can kind of verify that this is 100% just boric acid. And literally the way that you do that is by taking the container with the boric acid, turn to the back, go to the ingredients list, and the only thing that should be listed there should be boric acid. If there are additional ingredients, then you know that the product that you have is actually mixed with other things that are often not necessary. You want to get 100% boric acid with no other ingredients. And this is the most effective. In general, I would recommend using the boric acid a maximum of twice daily, 12 hours apart, for about 7 to 10 days. If you've tried this treatment and you have no change in your symptoms, your vaginal discharge, the smells that you have vaginally, then the next best step is to go to the doctors and be evaluated, be tested, and potentially also get antibiotic treatment, because that has been shown through evidence-based medicine to be the most effective for bacterial vaginosis. One of the best ways, however, that I think boric acid may help you in your future when it comes to infections would be to prevent those infections from happening. It's always better to prevent than to cure, right? We've heard that term. And so with that, I recommend starting your treatment first with your antibiotics from your doctor, so you know that for sure your infection has been completely cleared up. And if you're prone to getting bacterial vaginosis, then I would recommend that moving on and forward, that you use the boric acid as needed to prevent a future infection. Again, if you place more acid in the vagina, the likelihood of this infection becomes slim. The second thing that I would also recommend is investigate and try to figure out the cause of your BV. Why? Because if you know that sexual activity, for instance, tends to lead to you having BV, it would be best for you to then use boric acid maybe once following sexual activity to decrease the likelihood of you getting that infection. Or if you know that bacterial vaginosis occurs in your body after a menstrual cycle, then after your periods, then you can just add a suppository right at the end of your period to decrease the likelihood of you getting that infection. And so with using this intermittently, it can actually take you a very long way and help you to reduce the likelihood of getting a full-blown infection. In addition to that, I want you to also know that constant use of boric acid may lead to you having reactions in the vaginal area that are not so nice. And that includes having irritation, having chemical burns because you're putting a lot of acid in the vagina. And so we want to decrease the likelihood of these things happening. So you want to use boric acid only as needed and preventively by sporadically using it when you know that you've caused the insult to your vagina that would lead to you having an infection. I hope this makes sense. If you have questions or comments, please be sure to drop them below. Like and subscribe to this channel as well, because I constantly bring you information having to do with bacterial vaginosis, yeast infections, and so many other things that affect us as females. Also, I have a free gift for you today. My free hormone book, Hormones Don't Lie, is right below at the link. And I promise you, you'll get lots of great information in this book that will help you with your vaginal space, but also help you to create the environment inside that is perfect for you living your best life. Thanks for being here today. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN, and it's been my pleasure, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.